think the jurying process is interesting. Right away, I think I selected most of the works based on what I found interesting or what kind of pushed me to have questions about the work. Like, things that made me kind of look into them more, I immediately selected those works. I mean, I think as a jurying process, you're most of the time going from your own personal preferences of art, but then with this being a themed show on altered books, I wanted to consider kind of maybe the history of altered books, and then go back and look at the work and see where my own personal aesthetic and the aesthetic of this show could like combine. And I think there's a lot of good kind of overlap between these artworks, these pieces being artworks on their own, and these pieces being artworks for a specific show on altered books. Hi, my name is Eli Sho. I am originally from Sioux Falls. I am a working artist and a museum preparator right now. I've been on the East Coast for the past 5 years and recently moved back. I have had art shows around the country, New York, LA, Minnesota, kind of around the board. I've been recently writing a lot about art, blogging on the side, and then starting to write more theory lately. When I think of altered books, I really like to look at kind of the transformation of going from the book as an object to the book as an art object. I think the kind of back and forth play between like the history of something to your own personal expression has a lot to do with how art and language kind of function in our current society. I think we're always kind of wrestling with the past to kind of make something new. And the most of the entries I chose for this show, I think, were based on kind of, you could tell the artist considered the historical reference or considered the book as an object before destroying it, which I think is important. You should almost always understand kind of where you came from to go forward. Bound and Unbound 4, looking at the submissions as a whole, I noticed a lot of, I guess, variations on a theme. We're still working with the same sort of altered books as a way of, you know, creating art. And I think it's a really interesting combination of either considering the book or the information that this artwork comes from, or kind of using maybe the book more as like an icon to kind of pursue the artist's own intentions. But overall, I think the great submissions from a lot of different places. It's really surprising to see kind of everyone's tone from different parts of the country or from different parts of the world. I think it was hard to actually see or tell when something was from somewhere else. I think we all kind of speak a similar language when we look at old like books and artifacts and kind of the nuance or the icon of the book, I think, is similar in a lot of different cultures. There's a few pieces that I think really stuck with me. There's a fold-out one with a bunch of portraits that are seemingly from different time periods and different cultures, and I think it sort of impressed on me like a longer story, a longer narrative. And I think that's an interesting to kind of bridge that gap between like a single picture, a single object, and then to like the written language. I mean, I think with books you often spend more time because you read through them and they have a lot of, there's a lot more to it than the immediacy of what you first see, and I think there's two works in this show that kind of gave me that sort of feeling. There's this weaving over the top of a map, which I think is kind of like a retranslation of information into different forms, and I think that's a really great like icon maybe for this show. It's a great the weaving is this retranslation of information, and I think that's kind of like our connection to when we see words, we translate them into ideas. I kind of think like the purpose of books or of information is kind of to make us think about things in other ways, to like empathize. And I think empathy is like one of the most important parts of reading, and I think these two works, I guess, that I'm considering gave me the most empathy. Even though it's just a map, I think the retranslating of it kind of shows you how this information matches the real world and how it is completely different from the real world. Like, the weaving isn't the landscape it's trying to translate. It's almost like another obfuscation. That's a horrible word to say. But it's like another, like, false or another symbol for something that retranslates into a physical space, but where maybe like the accordion fold that is the family portraiture is another like retranslation of time and of space, and I think of maybe community and relation that I think a book also has, like the information from the beginning to the end is kind of like a transversing time. That's so hard. I'm trying to like clips.